Good morning, students. Class 9. How are you all? I hope all of you are fine and you're enjoying the online classes and you are doing your homeworks in each and every subject in your home, right? And this is your Nupur ma'am, and welcome back to your next English class. And without delaying our time, I will start today's class. But before that, I want to say, I told you the last day about the syllabus of your first unit test. Till 15th May, how much it was happened in NCERT book and in grammar, it would be in your first unit test, right? So, and last day I have given the last all practice work, so many practice work what I have given in the previous videos. Some students told me that they can't download properly, so that is why I have given the pictures of the practice work also. Please write down in your copy, okay? So today I will start the second chapter in your NCERT book, okay? That is the sound of music. The second chapter, the sound of music. There is two part. Okay, there are two parts, part 1 and part 2. So today I will start part 1. So the sound of music, this is the second chapter, and part 1 I will start. See the page I have written. This is your chapters. This is a chapter written. I have written in my own page. See, I hope you can see the video. The same in your book you can see, right? So the you can see the title. Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. Evelyn Glennie is a girl, is a teenager. She is 17 years old, a girl. And about her, author says the all lines. Okay. Evelyn Glennie, she is 17 years old and she is deaf person. She can't hear, okay, but she can sing wellly, okay? So you can imagine one person who can't hear by her own ears, but she can sing a song, okay? So see, Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. You can see the title. It's a very interesting title. Author says that Evelyn Glennie listens to sound. Means she can listen, she can hear, she listens to sound without hearing it. She can't hear it, but she can feel the sound. She listens the sound, okay? So this is a very interesting chapter, and you can see the title is very interesting, right? So before the chapter starting, there you can see some, like, before you read in your book you can see. Okay, see, God may have taken her hearing, but he was given her back something extraordinary. God may have taken her hearing. God has taken her hearing power, but he has given, but God has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels. What we hear, she can feel those. She can't hear, but she can feel those. Far more deeply than any of us. But there are very deepness more than of us. That is why she expresses music to beautifully, so beautifully. That is why she can express her music so beautifully. Okay? And the next, read the following account of a person who fought against a physical disability and made her life a success story. Read the following, you can see that a person who fought against a physical disability. Suppose someone can't hear, means suppose someone is deaf person. That means this is one kind of physical disability of that person, right? So that is why you can see a person who fought, right? Who fought against a physical disability and made her life a success story. Okay, she struggled a lot for his physical disability, but afterwards she got a successful life. And here you can see the successful story. Okay, so The story is totally of about Evelyn Glennie. She is a girl, she is 17 years old age, and she can't hear, but she can feel the music. Okay, so let us start today the second chapter, the first paragraph number 1. Rush hour crowds jostle for position on the underground train platform. A slight girl looking younger than the 17 years was nervous yet excited as she felt the vibration of the approaching train. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. See, I have written the meaning. Same pattern you can see in your book. Okay? The first page of this second chapter. Same pattern you can see in your book. Okay? So, I have managed it in the same pattern. Okay? So, this first paragraph is telling about Evelyn Glennie. And the scene of this story, there's a scene is a platform. Okay? And it is an underground platform. And there, so many crowds are there. The platform is very much crowded. And Evelyn Glennie, she's a girl. She's a 17 years old age. And she was waiting for the train at that platform. And when train was coming, she could understand the vibration of approaching train. When she felt that vibration of the train, she could understand the train was just coming. Train was just near to her. Okay. And she was waiting at the platform, and that is in Scotland, and she was going to Royal Academy of Music, that is in London. Okay. As you can understand, London is a very big country. This is a very big place, and their life is so fast. And in Scotland, there is life is not so much fast like London. Okay, Scotland is a very countryside place, and their farms are so many farms are there. So she is belonging from a small place, so that is why she is little bit nervous about that London, about that place. That as that place is very much fast, and as she is a teenage, in her age, this is a very big achievement. And on that moment, she is going to London, and she is leaving Scotland, and this is a big achievement. And she was feeling nervous on that moment. Okay, as she was profoundly deaf, totally deaf, so this was a big challenge for her. Okay, this is the main meaning of the first sample, first paragraph. See, rush hour crowd jostle. Jostle means push roughly. There is a crowd in the platform for position on the underground train platform. That is a platform I told, and this is an underground platform, and there are so many crowds are there. All are taking their own position. A slight girl. Slight, small and thin, small and thin. A slight girl looking younger than her 17 years was nervous yet excited. She was nervous, but she was excited as she felt the vibration of the approaching train. When she felt the vibration of the approaching train, it was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London. And daunting enough, daunting means frightening, scary. Okay, daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. As I told, she is from Scotland, and Scotland is not like London. Okay, Scotland's life is not so fast. Scotland, as London is an urban area, and the Scotland is a farm countryside area. So she was nervous about the place, also about the Royal Academy Music. That she was totally nervous. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was a profoundly deaf. Profoundly deaf means totally deaf. So she was like a aspiring musician. You can see a person who wants to be a musician. She wants to be a musician. So she was nervous, but she was excited and she was in a mood to take the all challenges. Okay, so I hope the first paragraph is clear to you. Go to the next paragraph, paragraph number 2. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. She lost her hearing power slowly. Gradual means slowly. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. Whenever Evelyn was 8-year-old, on that moment some incident was happened, and her mother recalled all the incidents of that time. Whenever she was waiting to play the piano, Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name and she didn't move. They called her, but she didn't move. That means she couldn't hear properly. Right. I suddenly realized she hadn't heard, says Isabel Glennie. Isabel Glennie is a name of Evelyn Glennie's mother. Okay. Isabel Glennie is a mother of Evelyn. So on that moment, she understood that, she realized that she couldn't hear. For quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness. Conceal means hide. Okay. For quite a time, Evelyn was trying to hide her growing deafness. Okay, that means she is losing her power to hear. She was hiding this from friends and teachers. Okay. But by the time she was 11, when she came to her 11 old age, her marks had, this is DETERIO, okay, deteriorated, and her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. So when she came to her 11, her marks had deteriorated. Deteriorated means, do you know? And her headmistress urged. Urged means, do you know? Urged means requested. Okay. And this means, try to guess. Definitely, I will tell you. Try to guess. So, when she came to 11 and her marks had deteriorated, and her headmistress urged her parents, requested their, her headmistress requested their parents to take her to a specialist, to the doctor. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired. It was on when she goes when she went to the doctor specialist, it was discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. Okay, it was a result that her nerve was damaged, and it was happened gradually, slowly. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aids, and their parents were advised to give her the hearing aids. Hearing aids means this is an instrument which helps you to hear properly. This is a fitted instrument which will fit to your ear. Okay. And sent to a school for the deaf. I think you know there is a school for deaf also. Deaf, blind, there are so many schools. So they are specialists, they are headmistress, they are specialist doctor. Gave them the suggestion about sending her to the deaf school, and about giving her the hearing aids and all. Okay, as she was losing her hearing power gradually, slowly, as all the nerves were being damaged. Okay, so this is the paragraph number 2. I hope you understand. If there will be any question, if there will be any inquiry, you can ask me in comment box. Okay. And there are so many words which you got newly. There are so many meaning. So I hope you can see the video properly. If there will be any problem to understand, definitely ask me. So there are so many words you will get. There are so many meaning. Jostle, slight, daunting. This is daunting, okay? D-A-U-N-T-I-N-G. Aspiring musicians. And there are lots of words in second paragraph also. Just like deteriorated. Its meaning reduced, okay? When her marks had reduced. Worst. Her marks was getting reduced, decreased, okay? Urged means requested, and some other impaired, weakened, hunting, hearing aids, you can understand, and gradual, slowly, or in phase, anything you can say, right? So there are so many words, you can write the meaning in your copy also, okay? So today it's just paragraph 1 and 2 I have completed. Wait for the next video. I will continue this chapter on the next day also. Okay, till then keep watching my video and read this chapter. Okay, thank you so much. Have a nice day.